Karen Wellman this morning from Dynamic Metals. Karen, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew.
More positive news out of Dordie Far West this morning here, these strong nickel grades. Tell us a bit more about them and just give us a recap on the program.
Yeah, some fantastic news out of Dordie this morning. Just after listing earlier this year in January, we went out to Dordie Far West, the prospect at Widgiemooltha. We've drilled 5 RC holes, which we're testing for Kambalda, Kamardiite type massive sulfide nickel mineralisation. So we drilled 5 holes on 4 sections, covering an area of about 300 metre strike, where previously Mincor had had a bit of success in drilling that they did in the mid-2000s. As part of that program, we took 3-metre composite samples, and last month we were able to report the preliminary assay results, which had indicated that the presence of thick, high-grade nickel intersections in 3 of the 5 drill holes. The reason for taking 3-metre composite samples, it's a bit of a cost-saving measure that we do in early-stage exploration, so we're not investing huge quantities of money in assaying if you don't have anything there. So by taking composite samples, you're reducing the overall number of samples you're taking, therefore keeping your costs low. So what we've done after we've got these results back a month ago, we've gone back out there to those 5 drill holes and we resampled areas of interest at 1-metre intervals rather than the 3 metres. And these are the results which we're presenting today. So results are pretty strong, very strong, especially considering we're still in the weathering profile. So they're not fresh rock intercepts, I'll clarify that. So some of the significant results we're presenting today is 16 metres at 1.96% nickel, which includes a zone of 5 metres at 2.84% nickel. So that, you know, that's highly significant. And there's several zones within the hole 3 as well, 12 metres at 1.56% nickel, 6 metres at 1.6% nickel. In addition to this, we've received some strong cobalt numbers in association with the nickel, with the highest cobalt assay coming in at about 0.5%, which is pretty high. So we're thoroughly encouraged by our success at Dordie Far West, and we're looking forward to our follow-up program. We've actually just received all of our approvals for that one, so it's the next priority in our exploration program.
So you say here, given the results, you're planning another 2 RC holes to the southwest, are you?
Yes. So we've planned 2 more RC holes on existing cleared lines, so that's why we'll be able to get the permitting done fairly quickly. So it's part of our measured approach to exploration. We're not going to try to take a big step out straight away. We'll just keep going on from what we know and build up the story in a strategic fashion.
Karen, the last time we spoke, this air core drill program at Lake Percy, that was underway. What's the latest there?
Yeah, so Lake Percy, our program has just finished up there this week, and the Dynamic team have just packed up camp and are heading back to the office. So we'll release a bit of a summary on that program shortly. The next cab off the rank after that is to go back out to Dordie Far West once the guys have had a break, and we'll drill those 2 holes sort of towards the end of May. And then after that, we've got 3 more programs, air core programs around Widgiemooltha that are permitted and ready to drill. So that's our Sunday Soak prospect, Mandilla and Higginsville. So we hope to get all those done by the end of the quarter.
And you've got sufficient cash to support these exploration plans?
Yes, we released our quarterly last week. So cash in the bank at the moment is $5.62 million after paying off all of our listing costs and associated costs with that. We've got a clear runway in front of us and plenty of work to get on with.
Good to speak, Karen. Thanks very much.
Thanks very much, Andrew.